Okay, so from a game design perspective, random loot drops are a very, very powerful tool to keep the players engaged and to have the players stay playing, keep on playing the game because they want better and more loot drops. So a proper loot drop system is pretty damn important if you want to make a very cool game that the people care to play. And there are not many, or not any tutorials I've seen on YouTube, or at least when I was designing my loot drop system, I couldn't find any tutorials. So I came up with something on my own, and I want to show you what I did there. So stay tuned. Welcome to the very first episode of GML, Game Maker Learning. My name is Alex, and today I will be showing you my approach to random loot drops. So let's get started. Okay, let's start by putting the resources to the left, because that's where they belong. And let's have a look what I have prepared here. So this is an example project I made with just some example assets, some sprites for loot drops, and some enemies which will drop the loot. A script which we will be filling, and then some empty objects, or partially empty, but yeah, we will go through them later on. Also, I made two rooms, an init room and an actual game room. Let's start with the init room. So here we have two instances in this room. An object init, which we will be using to initialize variables. That they basically, it's a good approach, and many of you game maker veterans will know this already, to have an initialization room start at the very beginning of your game, which takes care of all the variables you want to have present in your game. And that's basically just what this is. Also, we have a loot controller, which we will also going to program as a persistent object, which will then stay in the game. So much for that. Let's start with the init object, which is the object we will put in the init room. And it just has a create event. And in this create event, we have defined two macros, which will make our life much easier later on. So basically, for the scope of this project, that's the only reason we have this init object. So we have two macros at the beginning. So one is drop object, which is 0. And a macro for drop chance, which is 1. Then we just go to the next room, which is the actual game room. So yeah, just create this one really quick. And then we can start with the actual loot drop system. So let's take a close look, or a short look, how you could drop loot. So the most easy approach is if you go to the destroy event. So upon destruction of an enemy, you would simply you could simply create an instance of your loot at the exact same position and same depth or same layer, whatever. So that's basically how it could work. However, that would mean you only can drop one loot object, which is
quite limiting. You could, of course, use the choose function and drop either loot 1 or loot 2, for example. But that's still not really a viable option because it's limiting. Here we have 50% chance of dropping loot 1, 50% chance of dropping loot 2. Quite limiting. You could, of course, modify the odds a little bit by adding loot 2. Now it's a 25% chance of dropping loot 1 and a 75% chance of dropping loot 2. But still, not flexible at all. Especially if you have more than just 2 or 3 or 4 different kinds of loot. So yeah, let's not do this. What we will actually do is we will create a catalog, so to speak, of all the loot we have in the game. We will define loot tables because different types of enemies oftentimes have different loot tables. That means that a basic enemy drops basically the common stuff, and a boss enemy would drop the really legendary stuff. Yeah, so let's go to our controller object. So yeah, you create a controller object. It must be persistent because we put it in the first room, the init room, so that it stays in the game. You create this object once and just let it sit there to take care of all the loot dropping determination stuff. Right, so controller loot. It's pretty simple actually. We just have a create event for this one. And let me copy this over. So this is actually from a game I am working on. And I thought this would make a good video, I guess. Because I actually had a hard time figuring out how to implement a proper loot drop system. But yeah, I did and it works. So yeah, so our loot drop system. It's basically what I just told you. We have a pickups catalog array or loot drop catalogs array, whatever you want to call them. And we start by creating some enums for the drop tables, which will be the values for the enemy objects. Enums drop tables. We will have three kinds of enemies in this game. The regular enemies and elite enemy table and the boss enemy table. So here you would put as many or define as many tables as you would need for your game. As I said, you have to figure out how many different loot tables you need. For example, how many types of enemies you will have and how much the loot should differ they drop. And after you have defined those, you add a final enum for this, calling it total. Not that total. And it's just basically plus one. This is just a handy little thing we will use later for our code. Oh, right. And after this, the second enum we are going to do. Let me put this here. Um, Not pickups. Let's call them loot drops. And these are basically all the item classes you're going to drop, or the items you're going to drop. So for this example, we use common, rare, legendary, and exotic. I was kind of thinking of Destiny when I was doing this. But anyway, so let's start by defining an array, which is something you may not have to do, but it's the way I do it, because after creating and clearing this array with zero, we can use the at symbol as an accessor, which is, I don't know, I just like using accessors. So what we are doing now is we define the loot catalog. So basically we put stuff into the loot catalog. This is now where our macros come in handy. So use the accessor, then the drop object, and the first one we defined, the common one. We now link this one to an actual object. These are the objects I created, which are basically the drops. So the drops that are going to be collected. OJ, pickup, common. And also into the catalog, we put, or we define, the drop chance for this one. And so the common stuff is common. So let's go about 75%. So these values you will be entering here are percentages. Basically the probability, how probable it is that the loot will drop. So you have a 75% chance of a common loot drop. And let's just copy these because we are lazy, and then just use the Alt key to change those into rare. The object for the rare one is this one. Let's change the chance to like 60% for this one. Legendary. Um, 35% for a legendary seems okay. And exotic. Exotic is like, let's say 5%. Great. So that's our loot catalog. We now do some magic by defining the drop table content. What we are going to do is we put drop indices into arrays and use those arrays as tables for the loot drops. Pretty simple. So let's use a new create a new variable here. And this is basically the loot the drop table for the types of enemies. So we have a regular enemy. And let's call this, no, and now we put the loot drops that should be on this table into this array. So the regular enemy, or basically the regular drop table, just drops the common ones and the rare ones. But no legendaries, no exotics. What we will also have is an elite enemy. So basically like a mid boss or something, which drops some nicer gear. So it also drops the common stuff. And let's copy this. The rare stuff and also the legendaries. And the boss has an own loot drop table, and because it's a boss, if a boss drops something very ordinary, then the players would feel cheated. So the boss only drops legendaries and also the exotics. Okay, now for this all to work, we need an index of all the tables, which is basically we will put arrays into an array. So the drop table index contains the drop table regular array, the drop table elite array, and the drop table boss array. It is important at this point that because this is an array, and you know arrays work from zero upwards to n, that you use the exact numbers as we did here in the enums. So basically that's the reason why we put the numbers here, because basically you can just write them and it gets numbered the same way without you seeing those, but just to make sure and to double check. So 0 is the loot table for the regular enemies. Elites is 1. And 2 is for the boss. So that's basically the most important thing you have to watch out. Right. Oh, just referred once. Okay, that's correct. Okay, so that's that. Basically, that's our catalog. And now we will create the script, which will refer to the catalog and basically look into the catalog. What the system does, how you can think about it, is that we first check the enemy if they drop something at all, and if they drop something, then we basically like we pick a lottery ticket which has a number written on it, and then we check the number and see what loot it is on this lottery ticket. It sounds more complicated than it is. And yeah, let's just get into it. So we start by defining some local variables. which we will have to supply to the script whenever we call it. The probability, which is how... No. Which is the chance of getting a loot drop, and the table we will look on. And to make sure, if a probability is bigger than zero, because zero probability, oh, what's that? If a probability of 0% means nothing. And just to make double, to make sure there is a table defined, both have to be true. Right, so if it does drop something, or no, if it has some probability, then we will check. And this is simply doing an... God, it's very hot in here. I random range from 1 to 100, which is the percentage range. If it's smaller or equals to the probability, then we can check what to drop. So we first define some, or we define some more variables. Number of entries equals the array length of loot controller. Index table. So we look up how long exactly that array is. And also we define the drop table array, which equals the table we have just gotten the length of. Okay, so let's decide the total length of the probability spectrum. I don't even know if that's an actual word. I'm German, sorry. But I like the word. I think it makes sense. If it doesn't, let me know in the comments. So we first initialize these values, an incrementer here. And that incrementer can mean one or two things, no, several things actually. So we were going to use repeat function. Sorry, I just got thrown off here. Probability spectrum adds to that. Get a value from an array within an array here. And we increment and we repeat this as often times as there are entries. Once we have done this, we'll now pick a number within the spectrum Let's call that variable drop, and it equals a number within the range between 1 and the spectrum. So basically that's our lucky lottery ticket number. And once we have this, we check what item the picked number actually is. For this, we need some more local variables, because we verify spectrums from which have a beginning and an end. It may or may not make sense for you in a bit. And what we are going to use now is a for loop, which will loop through the whole thing and see what it actually is that we picked. So every time we loop through this, we start by setting up, like, we move the begin to the end of a one before, if it makes sense. And then we define the new end. Again, an array within an array we are getting. And then we check if the drop so we check if the drop is between the beginning and the end of that spectrum we are checking for verification. So if it's there, then we have our item index. Which we, of course, get out of the catalog. Right. Now that we, in the end, know what wait, didn't I miss some? Oh, right, yeah. Sorry, I missed one over here. I wanted to say. I had the feeling one was missing. Right, so two down and here. Now that we have the object index over here, in the end, we can create set loot drop. You would have to modify this to your project. So I use layer here and made a loot layer. You have to check what's working best for your project in terms of depth or layer. But I believe in you. You're big enough. You will figure it out. Right, and that is that. So this script works out if there's a loot drop or not, and if there is, which one it is, and then it creates this loot drop. Right, so for this to work, or better for us to check this, we have to add some values to the enemies. So I made a parent enemy object, which has a regular enemy, an elite enemy, and a boss enemy as its children. And what it does is, upon pressing left, it calls this script. So we click on either of those, and they supply the script with a variable called drop probab and drop table. These are by default. Why is it red? 0 and 2? But that's wrong. We supplied those. Yeah. We supplied those. Should go away. If we add it now, right, okay, never mind. So we supply those two. They are by default 0% and no one, just for a fail safe. And then we define them on a per enemy basis. So the regular enemy, he has a drop probability of 75%. So whenever we click on the normal enemy, there's a 75% drop chance that he drops something from the drop table, drop table's regular enemy table, which is the enum we created. We have to use this approach because otherwise it wouldn't work out with all those arrays. And for the elite enemy, it's a 50% chance that this one drops something from the elite table. And the boss, shouldn't it be higher that this one drops one? I don't know, but yeah. The boss, he drops always something. As I said, players would feel cheated if he wouldn't. And he uses this awesome boss table to check the loot. So pretty straightforward. It's just a test. And just for the sake of completeness, I made a parent object for all the loot, which has this loot in it. They don't even have anything in terms of events. What the parent automatically does is, upon creation, it moves this somewhere into the room, right? It just spreads the loot out. In the game room, here are our three enemies. The normal one, the elite, and the boss, which wears a gold chain and aviator sunglasses, because obviously he's the boss. So let's test this. Here's our room. Now we click on him. No, 75% chance. No. Okay, something common loot. Nothing, rare, 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 Nothing, nothing, common, rare, rare. Okay, 50% chance. But maybe we get, we get something legendary. Right. Now let's click on the boss. You know, 100% of dropping something with a 5% chance that it's a legendary. Oh, awesome. Yeah. So basically, that's the whole idea behind this. Pretty straightforward system. Right. You will find this demo project with all the codes on the marketplace, the Yo-Yo Games Game Maker marketplace, that is, for a couple of bucks, which is an awesome way for you to support my channel. And speaking of supporting this channel, if you want more of this content, then by all means, like and subscribe. If you think this sucks and or I should have done something better or differently, let me know in the comments. Maybe even hit me with a thumbs down. Maybe I deserved it, maybe not. But so much for that. And see you soon. Happy game making. Bye bye.